let's imagine. Imagine that it's dawn. You're lying in the bed as the first rays of the rising sun sneak into the windows and are falling on your eyes. In the distance, you can hear the birds chirping, signaling the start of yet another new, wonderful day. You lie in bed, you close your eyes, and you try to think of how your day is going to be and plan it out. Let's think of that moment. Let's all close our eyes, if you want, of course, and listen to this musical melody. Good morning, everyone. Well, let's open our eyes. Can anyone tell me what this instrument is that I'm playing? Anyone? That's right. It's the sarod. The sarod is a very popular North Indian or Hindustani classical instrument. The word sarod comes from a Parsi word sarood, which means music or melody. The sarod comes from its predecessor, the rabab, which is a popular folk instrument even today in many parts of the world. The rabab was brought into India a few centuries back by tradesmen from Afghanistan. And India being this land of unity and diversity, a melting pot of different cultures through centuries, accepted. And this folk instrument, the rabab, thus got transformed over many generations because of the seminal work of many great musicians in the bygone era and took the shape of the modern sarod as you see it today. There are some structural variations to the sarod depending on the different styles of playing. However, every sarod today is made of a hollow wooden frame. There is a goat skin here for acoustics. There is a steel frame which is fretless, on which the musician has to play with the tip of his or her fingernails to get the sound out. And there's a brass tumba here for amplification of sound. My sarod, as you see, has 25 strings. It takes some time to tune. Well, there are 8 main strings here. There are 2 strings here for melody, called chikari, and there are 15 sympathetic strings called tarafs. The sarod was developed in such a way that it can mimic a large variety of frequencies and tones, like different bass and treble. I'll try and give a small demonstration of that by playing a very popular Western classical piece. Thank you. missing summer. I know I am. Well, that's quite a few of you. Well, friends, my home is in Kolkata. Kolkata is a big city in the eastern part of India. And believe me, the lowest temperature that you ever get is around 10 degrees centigrade. Yeah. So when I was applying for grad school here in the US, my first criteria was it should be a warm place. Well, yeah, I mean, Georgia Tech is really good, but yeah, I chose Atlanta for that. So, as hot as it gets here in Hotlanta, it's really much, much more warmer from the places that I come from. It can get unbearably hot. So let's try and imagine for a moment that it's one such hot and humid day, the hottest day possible that you can think of. Maybe in Texas. It's really hot, and you're really sweating a lot. You look up at the trees, and you see that not a single leaf is moving. There's no wind, and you feel like making a silent prayer to anyone who hears you that, someone, please bring down the temperature somehow. Let me get some relief. It's just, I can't live like this. Just imagine such a thing. Suddenly, you hear the sound of thunder. The sky changes color, clouds rush in from all directions. It suddenly becomes a really, really cloudy day with flashing lightning and thunder. And it starts to rain, and rain heavily. And your heart dances with joy because your prayers have been answered. Let's think of such a moment. Let's think of such a scene. Let's close our eyes on that and think that it's starting to rain. Oops. Well. Technical difficulties, I guess. Back so many memories from my childhood. because it was on one such rainy day that my parents first took me to my first music teacher when I was all of 4 years old. His name is Jayanta Rai Chaudhary, and I affectionately call him Master Moshai, which means headmaster, a teacher. I remember vividly that he refused to take me, saying I was too small. But then I took an immediate liking to this instrument. So the way I used to play was like this, because I could see my reflection in the steel plate. And as a child, that used to be the biggest attraction for me for this arrow. I remember I was so small that I couldn't even hold this plectrum properly. This plectrum, by the way, is made of coconut shell, and it is called the jeva. So Master Moshai had me have marble balls in my hands. I was like four or five years old then. And then I was holding the plectrum so that I had enough strength. I could develop enough strength in my hands to properly, it's like a medical ball that you have these days. So I used marble balls. And I had my first concert when I was 6 years old, and it has been a great journey ever since. When I was around 12, my first teacher, Jayanta Rai Chaudhary, he handed me over to my present teacher, my present guru, Pandit Alok Lahiri, for my further musical development. Pandit Alok Lahiri is one of the best known sarod players alive today, and it's my privilege and honor to be his disciple and to learn so much from him. I remember spending days at end at his home trying to master the finer arts of this, of Indian classical music and of the sarod. Because my guru tells me that it's not enough to be a skilled musician, but it is also important to be a very good human being and to conduct oneself as a good musician, because in Indian classical music you're representing a culture and a tradition which is thousands of years old. So you're representative of that ancient tradition. Well, music for me is more than just a passion. It's the oxygen that helps me go on my daily duties and to focus on other things as well. Music, my friends, is a great connector between people. It transcends all boundaries, all human-made boundaries, race, religion, politics, everything. And it's a great binding force, especially in today's world. Music also helps me as a person, because I'm a bit of an introvert by nature, but when I'm on the stage, it's completely different. Because through music, I can express my deepest feelings, my deepest emotions, with a bunch of unknown faces here. I don't know most of you, but I feel at home through music and through my instrument, through my sarod. Well, and Indian classical music is all about creativity and innovation, because there is very little pre-scripted or pre-composed part to Hindustani classical music or Indian classical music. An artist can never exactly replicate what he has played in his previous concert or in any concert in his life, because there is always innovation, there is constant creation that goes on in Hindustani classical music. Now, having talked about my own journey in music, let me talk briefly in more technical terms about the compositions that I was playing and about my music. The heart and soul of Hindustani classical music is a series of complex musical patterns with defined descending and ascending parts to them, which we call rag. These complex music patterns of notes were developed hundreds, sometimes even thousands of years back. And they were passed down generation by generation from the guru or the teacher to the disciple or the shishya, following proper musical tradition or parampara. And this teacher-disciple tradition or guru-shishya parampara is one of the cornerstones of Hindustani classical music. These complex melodic patterns have also been differentiated by ancient musicians and philosophers for maximal impact on human beings and human emotions on times of the day or seasons of the year. It's very intriguing and interesting that an ancient art form has gone into such depth in demarcating these complex musical melodies, because today Indian classical music is increasingly being used in music therapy. And there is a lot of study being done on how music can affect the state of mind. So there are so many therapeutic effects of Hindustani classical music as well. So coming back to this complex melodic patterns and rags, the first composition today that I played, it was an early morning complex melodic pattern or rag, rag Ahir Bhairav. Whereas the second one was rag Miyanki Malhar. Well, it is said that if a musician plays Miyanki Malhar perfectly, he can invoke rain by pleasing the rain gods. We human beings are complex people. We are multidimensional. We can be happy, but also we can be sad at the same time. We can love someone, but we could also hate something about that same person. And that's what makes us human. We want to be somewhere, but also to be somewhere else. And these complex human emotions can also be represented by Hindustani classical music, by certain complex rags. So my last presentation for this night is going to be such a complex rag, rag Mishra Pilu. I'm going to request you to close your eyes and just think about the various range of emotions that you feel. It's not an unidimensional emotion that you will feel, I hope, if I play it right. There will be happiness, sadness, melancholy, and lot of different feelings. So, let's see how it goes.